Mode. So today concept name is POM. Simply we can say page object model framework, or we can say POM, page object model framework, POM. Page object model framework, page object model, this is framework. So we can say page object model framework. So what is page object model framework? POM is a POM is a design pattern to create object repository for web UI elements. First point, POM, page object model, is a design pattern to create object repository for web UI elements. I will explain you. Next, under this model, for each web page, in the application, there should be corresponding page class. POM, page object model framework. So it is totally different framework, madam. So here what we need to do, under this model, for each web page in the application, there should be corresponding page class. So here page object model. So for example, I am taking one page. So like if you take Facebook, one page. In the Facebook, we have some elements, web elements. So like we need to enter username, we need to enter password, we need to click on sign in button. Only three elements. Only for that three elements, we will maintain corresponding page class. First point, POM is a design pattern to create object repository for web UI elements. So each and every web application having web elements. So each and every web element, we will maintain corresponding, each and every web element, we will maintain one repository. That is the first point. Each and every web element, like we need to enter username, we need to enter password, we need to click on sign in button. Only the three element purpose, we will maintain object repository. Second one. Only for the three elements in the application, we will maintain corresponding page class also. So if it is any web elements change, any UI elements change, any property change, there is no need to change all the structure or all the script. Just we will change in only one place. So that's why that is called page object model framework. Page object model is a design pattern to create object repository for web UI elements. Under this model, for each and every web page in the application, there should be corresponding page class. So what is the use of page object model? Page object model framework has nowadays become a very popular test automation framework in the industry, and many companies are using this framework. And because of its easy test maintenance and reduce the time and duplication of the code. So what are the main uses? So main use is we can easily maintain. Second one is reduce the time. Third one is duplication of the code. So that's the reason nowadays all the companies, they are using this page object model framework. POM is a nowadays become very popular test automation framework in the industry. Okay. Second use. The main advantage of page object model is if the UI changes for any page, if it is any UI changes, UI means user interface, like, you know, if it is any property change, if don't require us to change any tests, we just need to change only the code within the page objects only. So if it is any property change, no need to change in all pages, only at one place, that is page objects, we need to change. So it is very, very important framework, madam. With example, I will show you, you can get it. Before going to this concept, just we should know constructor. Constructor. What is constructor? So this is the actually I need to tell in first class only, madam. So if I teach first class itself, then you can feel it is very confused. So first class, static properties and non-static properties. So that time only I need to tell this concept, but right now I'm teaching just now. So what is constructor? Constructor is something which is used for constructing an object very easily. Constructor. What is constructor? Constructor. Constructor. Actually, this is Java concept, madam. So only here only we can use constructor. What is constructor? Constructor is something which is used for constructing an object very easily. Constructor is something which is used for constructing an object very easily. We can construct all the objects very easily. So we discussed one of the concepts, static properties and non-static properties. So for example, I am taking one boy class. All the boys not having some common properties. That properties is called non-static properties. All the boys not having some common properties. That properties is called non-static properties. What are the properties all the boys not having commonly, like name, color, weight, height? These are the non-static properties. So these four non-static properties I want to write in single line. So how we can write? So syntax. Syntax modifier, class name, modifier class name, data type, argument 1, data type space argument 1 comma data type space argument 2, like we can write number of properties. Like we can write number of properties. How many properties you want, that many properties we can write it. Okay. Next. So how we can write the properties? Modifier. So there are four modifiers, so access modifiers, there are four. One is public, private, default, protected. Okay, public. And taking class name is boy. Okay. So how we can write boy? Next, data type. Data type. I want to store four properties in single line. So name, string data type. String n, comma. Next, color. This is also string. String c, comma. And next, weight. Weight. Oh, we can take integer or double. We can take anything. Okay. Weight. Sorry. Weight. Text. No, not string. Int or double. Double I am taking. Double. W. Comma. Height. Height also we can take double. D-O-U-B-L-E. Double height. We can write it. So next to what is n? N equal to name. C equal to color. H equal to I2. W equal to way to. Like we can write. So this is the constructor. So in the single line, if you don't know constructor concept, each and every time we should write public boy string name, public boy string color, public boy double weight, public boy
double height,
we should write. But if you know constructor concept, in the single line only we can complete it. In the single line only we can complete it. So this is the constructor. Constructor is nothing but it is something we can constructing an object very easily. Easily, simply we can construct the object. So that is a constructor concept. So actually this is the first concept. So static properties and non-static properties, then only we need to discuss. But not only yours, in each and every batch I am, we will discuss end of the concept, page object model framework. Here only we will discuss. Here we will use constructor. So up to now, we didn't use constructor concept. Just here we need to use constructor. That's the reason right now. If I teach constructor now, then you can remember what is constructor, how we can implement constructor concept. That's the reason I'm teaching end of the course, like, right. So just go to concept. Today concept is page object model framework, POM. Before going to page object model framework, we need to take one site. Oh, which is the best site to go to Google? Orange charm. I'm taking this site. Here we need to give username and we need to give password. We need to click on login button. Only in this page we have three web elements. We have only three web elements. We need to enter username, password, and we need to click on login button. This is my task. So only for this three element purpose we will maintain object repository. How we can maintain object repository, I will teach you. So just go to src, take the new class. Class name is login. I am taking class name is login. Already is there? Yes. log in double n. Click on finish. So here I am writing the constructor page object model framework concept. So it's very easy, and you should remember, madam. So it's not just like test ng. First, take static web driver. Static web driver. So this is called global declaration WD. So I'm taking static web driver WD. This is global declaration. By dot by username. Username equal to by dot id. So give the id property or use XPath, whatever you want you can give it, madam. So here is no restriction. So if you want give the id, you can give it to, or name property you can give it to, or XPath, that's your choice. Whatever you want you can give it, here is no restrictions. Control V. Right, so go and get the first, import the statements in web driver by right username. Why it is showing username? Oh, username PWD password
login
right by. Import the statement by right. So go and get the usernames id property. If you want get the id property, you can give it id, madam, or XPath you can give it, madam, that's your choice, madam. Username XPath I am taking. Copy. Control V. Next, password. Go and get the password id. Txt password. Copy. Control V. Sign in or login. Login. Copy. Control V. Over, madam. Right. I gave username and password. This is okay.
Now,
so we need to create the constructor. How to create the constructor? Okay. Modifier, public, class name, login, argument 1, web driver, property name WD. This is the constructor, madam. Right, why it is showing error? See, we can this dot WD equal to WD. Why it is showing error? Class name is login double n. Oh, right. Web driver. Okay, constructor is over. Next, what we need to do? So we need to write the functions. How we can write the functions? Public void type username. I gave name is username. This spell is correct too. You should write username. So username enter bracket begin WD dot find element. So I gave name is username. So that name only you should give here, username dot send keys. So send keys is already username is caps. cap CA admin, pass ID is admin. Okay, right. Cap CA admin, admin. Right. I wrote one function for username. So next we should write for password. Copy. Control V. Control V. Right. Next type PWD. So here also we should give PWD. Small A. We need to click dot click. So this name is, I gave, what is the name? Login. Okay, all right, no problem. Type username, type click log. Okay, I wrote code, madam. Save. Right. Now I am taking another class. That class name is, go to src, take the new class. Class name is, for example, Maria. So I'm taking test engine annotation at the rate test. After writing test, we should write function public void check. Any function you can take it to check. Next, I want to open the site too. So how we can open the site? Web driver WD equal to new Firefox driver. Next, I want to open this site to WD dot get site name, copy paste. This is the test engine annotation.
Okay, sir.
Site name, copy, control V. Right. Next, we need to create the object login. Why? Because all are non-static functions. So if it is non-static functions, if you want call from another class, so we should create the object to log. Double G, I am giving you log, login, reference name log equal to new login, class name login WD. Over. So I want to give username and password, and we need to click on log dot double G, sorry, log dot username. What I gave, type username, type username, type PWD,
type.
Click log.
Click now.
Why it is showing Firefox driver? Login, log. Dot. Type username, type username, right. Next, log dot type pwd next click log click log log dot click log right enough madam so here observe carefully this is the object repository madam this is object
okay,
repository
okay.
If it is any web element property change we will change go here only 1 2 3 so remaining code is same to same remaining code is same to same here also same to same so if it is any changes we will change in only one place save click on run so it will go to site it will enter the username and password it will click on login button that is the concept of page object model framework so here I am taking very less only 3 web elements I am taking if it is any big application
yes,
that time we should take how many web elements have in the page that many functions we should write here so here only I have only 3 functions 3 web elements so that's the reason I wrote only 3 if it is 100 100
okay.
100 we should mention so if it is any web element
okay.
property change then we need to change here only remaining concept is same to same
okay, sir expert iskocha sir mari
yes madam
akkada manamu అక్కడ అక్కడ మీరు బై డాట్ ఐడి దగ్గర ఎక్స్పర్ టిఎక్స్టి యూజర్ నేమ్ అని రాస్తారు కదా ఎక్స్పర్ట్ తీసుకోవచ్చా సార్
ఎస్ యూ కెన్ టేక్ ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఆల్సో ఓకే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ లాగిన్ ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ కాపీ ఎనీ దట్స్ యువర్ చాయిస్ మేడం ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఎనీ వన్ ఎనీ ఎక్స్పర్ట్ సో గివ్ ద ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఇయర్ కంట్రోల్ వి సో జస్ట్ చేంజ్ ఇయర్ ఓన్లీ రిమైనింగ్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఈ సేమ్ టు సేమ్ No need to change any way. Save, click on run. Yes, it will click on login button. That is the concept of page object model framework. You can take XPath or ID property, any property you can take.